When I first came from Iran to Indiana, my favorite thing was my big wheel. I'd ride it every day from the front of our complex to the far end of the international housing complex at Purdue University. I usually raced my best friend, Zan.
Yeah.
It was dinner time for him, though, so I was going back and forth by myself, while my mother barbecued some shish kebab over a tiny black grill on our front patio. Is it ready yet? My mother had already cooked everything and thrown a cup of water onto the fire to put it out when I pulled up for a third time.
Rice is not ready yet, Piruz, she said in Farsi.
I looked inside the apartment and saw my dad with all his classmates. They were watching TV and talking loudly.
Wash your hand if you come inside, Piruz, my mother told me. Maman, man mikhan bazi mikonam, I said in Farsi.
I watched my mom through the kitchen window pull the kebabs from the sinks and step away to the rice with tadig sib zemini in another pot on the stove. Tadig sib zemini was my favorite. She would boil the rice halfway, empty it out, pour some oil on the bottom of the same pot, put slivers of potato on there, and then lay the rice back on top so the potatoes would fry on the bottom and infuse the rice with the smell and slight taste of fried potatoes. Then she'd flip the whole thing over like a cake, add saffron, and I was in heaven. My mom only made potato tadig when we had guests, so I was glad my dad's friends were there, even though they watched the news all the time and I couldn't watch Scooby-Doo. At least I'd eat tadig. I was about to go back on my racing circuit when I noticed the grill was still smoking. I watched the wind blow and rattle the grill, and a few small embers grew bright red, and I got excited. I secretly love fire, because I love the Lone Ranger. They were always making smoke signals on that show. I figured I could be just like them. That's when it hit me.
And now on Channel 6, Persian Cowboy.
I ran over to the bushes and pried a stick loose to cook the end of it. I figured I could burn it into an arrow to go with my plastic knife from Sears. I stuck the stick deep into the charcoal and waited. It caught fire pretty quickly. I jumped and flicked the stick against the grill to put it out. When I did that, I noticed a piece of charcoal fly and land in the bushes next to our front door. I got down on my knees and looked for the charcoal, but I couldn't find it. Then Jeremy showed up. He was my other best friend besides Zan. We usually played G.I. Joes or rode our big wheels because he ate dinner later, like us. Let's go, Jeremy yelled to me from his big wheel. I got on my big wheel and chased after Jeremy. He was older than me and a foot taller, so he was pretty fast. I figured I could catch him before he got to the end of the sidewalk. I started pushing the pedal so fast that the plastic of the front wheel was having trouble gripping the cement. 10 feet, 5, 2. I was gonna beat Jeremy today. I was even thinking of what to say as I passed him. Then Jeremy stopped and was looking out at the street. Beat you, I said and flew past him. Then I heard it, the blip sound, and then the large roar as two fire engines turned the corner to our block and headed straight for our complex. Fire engine, Jeremy yelled. A bunch of other kids who were outside started to scream it too. Fire engine! I had never seen a fire engine or firefighters. I got so excited, I thought maybe we could go on top of one. Let's go, I yelled to Jeremy. We headed back as fast as we could. Our eyes were on the fire trucks the whole time as we pedaled faster and faster. The firefighters were rushing out of the truck with hoses and yelling things at each other. Some had red helmets with yellow stripes. Others had black helmets. I wanted a black one. I was pedaling as fast as I could now. The firefighters were right in front of our building, right by the bushes. Then I remembered. The charcoal. I yanked the handle of my brake and put my feet down. I had forgotten all about it. Now it was all my fault. I started getting really scared. The firefighters might take me to jail. Then I got even more scared when I thought about what my dad would do. I almost started crying right there. You coming or what? Jeremy asked, waving his hands in front of my face. I hadn't moved at all. I just watched the firefighters put the fire out. Come on, Jeremy said and rode right near the trucks. I followed him slowly, watching one firefighter yelling things at all the others. He had his hands on his hips and a big mustache. I figured he was the boss. I went over and stood behind him. I was about to tell him what happened when my mother came running up to me, screaming in Farsi, "Pesar man, kucha rafti, tora khoda mercy." I wanted to tell the firefighter and not my mom what happened because I knew she'd get mad. She started screaming right away.
"Piruz, you start the fire. What are you thinking? This is dangerous."
Then my mom took me to the head firefighter. I told him what happened and he was very angry. His eyebrows looked like a V, like birds flying in the sky.
and he kept pointing to the grill and then me.
If I ever catch you playing with fire again, you're gonna be in big trouble, he said. Never, ever, ever play with fire.
I didn't like that he was yelling at me. I started crying and told him he was a bad person for yelling. Then my dad came out of the house. I hid behind my mom. The firefighter was talking to my dad. Then my dad came over to me. I started crying and said sorry right away.
Pirus, you cannot play with fire, my dad said. This is dangerous. You could have burned the whole house, all the neighbor. This is their life. People could have got hurt.
I'm sorry, I said.
You remember the ant?
I nodded my head.
Think how much a human life is worth. If an ant is 1 million and a bumblebee is 2, how much is human being?
A lot, I said.
Is infinite, Pirus. Is infinite.
My dad shook his head. I felt so ashamed. I ran inside and put my blanket over my head in the living room so no one could see me. I cried and cried. I thought about hurting people and cried again. Then I stopped. My dad was watching TV with his classmates. They were all talking in Farsi and their voices were getting very loud. I peeked out from under the blanket and saw the television. People were on the streets saying things in Farsi. Some of them were saying things like death to Satan and death to America. I didn't really understand. Then my dad's friends left and I went to bed. My mom and dad were talking in Farsi. I tried to listen, but I couldn't understand what they were saying because they were whispering. So I crept to the hallway. Then my mom saw me.
Back to bed, quick,
she yelled to me in Farsi. I ran to my room and went straight to bed.
What was it? What was it? Oh, good. You're getting so good. You're like a professional actress. I don't even know what to say. You're getting too good. Oh, my God. That's so great.
Yeah. How is the reaction of the people?
They say that that I'm okay. They said, you're okay, Pierce, but your mom is the star.
Ha ha.